Hello! In this video, we will see the workflow to use Plask animation in Reallusion character, and we will use it in Unreal. Import the video from which you want to extract the motion, and select the area in the video that you want to extract. To extract the condition of a single person, select Single Tracking and choose the option to insert a T-pose in the first frame for retargeting. Drag and drop the extracted motion to apply it to the rigging model, and check that it has been applied correctly by visualizing it. Right-click to open the Export menu and select the FBX, Unreal Engine, option for the format. We will export it with 3D Exchange, a free program provided with Iclone7 and Character Creator 3. Open 3D Exchange and first bring in the rigging for Unreal Engine. We will upload the iAvatar file used here in the description section. Now, import the file extracted from Plask and click Add to Platform to add it to the timeline. Rename this animation to a name without special characters or spaces and export it to Iclone7. Please set the directory name to be the same. Now we will open Character Creator 3 and export the character to Iclone7. In Iclone7, find the animation that we exported from 3D Exchange earlier and add it to the character. Additionally, you can create a layer and modify part of the animation. We will modify the hands in IK mode. Select the animation and export it in iClone format. Now, we will export an FBX file from Character Creator 3 that Unreal Engine can reference. Select Unreal as the target tool and choose Mesh and Motion for the FBX option. Before opening the Unreal project, you must have the free Reallusion plugin for Unreal installed. This plugin can be downloaded from the official page of Reallusion software. Download it according to the Unreal version you are using and copy it into the Unreal project folder like this. Import the FBX that was extracted into Unreal and make sure the Reallusion plugin is active. To bring the FBX from Reallusion to Unreal with high quality shaders and general settings, select HQ. Now, we will create a sequencer to check the character and animation. Create a folder with the desired name. Add the character to the sequencer so that you can add the animation. In this way, you can check the Reallusion character and Plask animation in Unreal. This has been a guide on how to bring the character and animation from Plask through Iclone7 to Unreal. Try Plask for free at www.plask.ai.